Okay, now I'm going to build off of the Weibull curve that we've just put together in Excel, and we're going to look at the power in the wind, and we're going to compare the power in the wind from just using an annual average wind speed versus using the power in the wind using the wind distribution. So first, you'll see that I've noted we have used a lambda of 7. That's the what we had used in our equation over here, and a k of 2. And using this information, we can find the annual average wind speed, u bar, using the equation that I've pasted in here from the notes. So it's going to be lambda, which is 7, times. Now, I'm going to show you how to use the gamma function. So what we really want here is gamma natural log, and we're going to take it as a function of 1 plus 1 over k, which is the cell. And since it's taking the natural log, we actually need to take the exponent of that whole value. Okay, and so we get 6.2. And that seems about right because usually the lambda or the scale factor is usually a little bit larger than the annual average wind speed. So if we were to just take this wind speed and calculate power with it, the power in the wind at that wind speed would be 0.5 times, we're going to use a density of 1.2, and we're going to do this on a per unit area basis, so it's going to be power density rather than power, times this velocity cubed, and that would be in watts, so 143 watts per meters squared. Okay. Now, if you take that times the number of hours in a year, roughly 8760, you get this number, and again, that's going to be now watt hours per meter squared. So all you have to do is multiply that by the swept area of a turbine to see what the total power per unit area on average would be going through the turbine at that site at that wind speed. And now doing the same thing over here for each one of our bins, we're going to have to do the same thing. 1/2 times 1.2 times our velocity cubed, but now we're going to take it times the fraction of the year that it sees that velocity, which is your Weibull density function. Okay? And then repeat that down the column. And now what I'm going to do is sum that up. Sum that whole column up. Okay, and I get 273. So let's move that over here and compare that with the 143 watts per meter squared that we got before. And then if I just multiply that by the number of hours in a year, again, you can see these should be proportionally similar, but let's just take 273 divided by 143. You can see you get almost twice as much power out of that area per unit area using the Weibull distribution, which is what is reflective of what really happens with the wind, rather than just using a constant wind speed value.